Oh, good morning, everybody. Oh, good evening. Almost a good morning. Good evening, good evening, good evening. How are you all this fine, fine Sunday evening? Hope you all have had a wonderful weekend. I'm just kind of hanging out, man. I did a bunch of yard work, so my body is hurting. And I really just want to go to sleep, but I'm not going to. So, yeah. But let's go ahead and get started. I played Invisible Touch by Genesis or Phil Collins, whichever one you want to go with there. Now we're going to listen to a little Osric Tentacles tonight, because why not? I don't know if this is going to work. I'm trying to get this, we're painting a 3D printed hand this evening, which is this cute little thing here. Maybe a little washed out in the upper left hand corner there, but that's what it looks like. My friend Chris Perkins printed this out and handed it to me and said, "Oh, paint it up, see what you think." So I got some ideas on how I want to do it. But first, we need to get a base coat on there, and I've used a little bit of witchcraft purple, ooh, spooky, for this, because I want it to kind of have that alien purpley. Feel to it. Then it gives it kind of a nice skin tone here. Especially over that ocean blue primer. Break out the big brush tonight for this, which is nice. Come on, stick on there. I need a little bit more of that purple. Off my holder. On there. There we go. So getting closer and closer to Halloween. Tuesday's the day. Tomorrow we're going to be painting up the banshee that I've been holding on to. So that should be a ton of fun. Can't wait to paint her up. Gonna try and make her look as ethereal as possible. that's just not gonna hold on. Okay, put my finger in there. I'm gonna dry this here. Hold on just a second. Okay, so after drying it, I can still see a lot of primer still. That purple just is not covering. So I gotta switch up plans and grab a different primer. Or not a different primer, a different purple. After I get all this poster putty taken care of here. This didn't work the way I wanted it to. Oop, stand. See, that's how it's... You can mount it on a wall. It's got a little mount. It's got a mount hole. So. Alright. So go with some Pro-Curl purple here instead of the Witchcraft purple. A little bit brighter and it should cover everything I need it to cover. Oh yeah, it's a lot brighter. Holy cow. Look at that. Look at that, barely any any primer peeking out. Thank you. Okay. It's fine. Everything's fine. Didn't break it, so that's good. Okay, I gotta try it again here. Hold on. Okay, well, definitely more purple. Can still see a little bit of the blue primer showing through, but I think that's okay. So we're just gonna start getting more of the skin tone on there. So I'm gonna grab a little bit more purple here. Then we're gonna grab some ghoul skin. And we're gonna mix this together along with some regular ghoul skin. Just gonna do a little bit of overbrushing here. It's really that purple down in the recesses. Kind of hard to see, but that's fine. Thank you. Now we're going to take some of that ghoul skin. You notice that I haven't washed out my brush. I want these colors to blend. So I haven't washed out my brush at all. I'm just mixing as I'm going. This is more of an overbrush than it is a dry brush. I haven't wiped a lot of paint off. I can start seeing some of that green come through. Really starting to bring out the texture of that skin, you can see. Didn't realize it was that texture, that's really cool. So, you know, we got that green on there, but you still see that purple underneath, starting to look pretty eerie. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna mix moldy skin into our ghoul skin. Now we're going to just use the moldy skin. I'm actually going to grab a different brush here. Don't want to dry brush the entire thing. I feel like it's boring. You see, I'm just using the edge of my brush, or not the, yeah, just the edge of my brush to go along these. It's still wet. It's a wet paint. We're not dry brushing. We're just kind of getting in some of these secondary midtones here. Same with the knuckles here. Alright, so there's our moldy skin. Now we're going to take a little bit of bloodless skin. We're going to mix that in to our moldy skin. Just gonna start going through here. Still leaving the purple in the recesses, also still leaving some of that regular moldy skin in there. Thank you. I think if I got this hand again, if my friend Chris prints it out again for me, I would paint it maybe a little bit differently. I wouldn't use the purple. I think maybe I would go with like a straight up flesh color. I'm not sure what straight up flesh color I would use, but I think I would do that. Really using the point too much. I'm using it to hit a couple little areas. Other than that, I'm using like the side of my brush to kind of get some of those raised areas here. So you got that like that. Well, that's looking pretty good. So now we're going to take straight up bloodless skin here. Get that thinned out well. One nice thing about these 3D printed pieces is that, especially with at this size, at least for me anyway, you don't really have to worry about being smooth, because there's so much texture to it already. So you're not trying to smooth it out, you're just trying to create little variations in the skin. Like that. that's all we've got for the skin. We're going to move on to the fingernails here. Oh, this is khaki. That's not what I want. Bone shadow. Looks pretty darn good. just going to dry this here real quick. Just going to turn my mic off for a second so I don't blow your eardrums out with the hair dryer. Give me 1 second. Okay, now we're going to go and we're going to mix some of our aged bone into our bone shadow. Andre252K followed. Thank you for the follow. I appreciate that. You must have been looking down when you did it. I apologize for not calling you out. Hey, Jeff. At this point, you'd be quoting Emma Thompson and Judi Dench and Henry V. Und the fingers. One of the fingers? Yeah, well. How you doing tonight? Painting a large demon devil guy from Badger Games, Frostgrave. Oh, that's cool. Problem with large bracers on the mini, they stick out and are solid like a small wall, but in real life you might see the arm underneath them. Yep, that's true. Or you'd see the shirt underneath it or something like that. Well, I could kind of show you what I did with a figure that's got bracers. Give me one second here and I'll show you. So what I'm going to do with this guy is I'm going to highlight basically starting from here. I'm going to leave this in shadow. Basically starting from here, I'm going to highlight up like this. And then I'll leave a dark line right there so that there's a demarcation line basically from where the wrist hits to where it ends up on the shirt. So like with this one, the sunlight coming down here, the highlights are going to be up here like that, and everything else down here is going to be in shadow. I'd probably start the highlight there and come bring it up all the way over like that. But again, leaving that demarcation line dark from where it hits the hand to where it hits the shirt. Yeah, it just makes, for my brain, it makes sense. straight up aged bone now. Could my stick on it have a lich hand back scratcher? Yeah, that might be a good idea. Surprisingly enough, it is meant to be mounted this way, so it actually can hold something. So if you, I think it's that way. Anyway, it's supposed to be mounted so that you can actually hold something on it, which I think that's pretty awesome. Bottle of liquor, that could lift your spirits. Bottle of liquor, and it could lift your spirits. There you go. And this is our polished bone, so I'm going to mix that into our aged bone and then use it by itself for our final highlight. Speaking of spirits, we're going to be working on the Banshee tomorrow night. For our Halloween show, we're going to be working on a Banshee. A spirit in the night, so right, yep. move to a smaller brush because I just want to be able to get the tip of the nail here. Like so. Well, I mowed my lawn for the last time today for the winter. Mulched a bunch of leaves. And we got the snowblower out yesterday, made sure it would start. Then we Well, I guess I should say, Kim was busy doing other stuff. I covered up the air conditioner for its long winter's nap. So we are ready for winter now. We bring it on. We can be snowed in, I don't care. They're talking about snow here in Minnesota tomorrow. They'd also been talking about snow here on Friday and Saturday, but that never appeared. It showed up down south, but it never got up here to central Minnesota. I'm okay with that. The The precipitation type that shall not be named. Yes, it is a four-letter word. We try not to say those on the stream. As a family show. We got friends coming in from Milwaukee next weekend. So I will not be streaming on Sunday. They're in town until, I think, at least Monday. If not Tuesday. If they're in town still on Monday, I won't be streaming Monday night either. But I think they take off on Monday. Take off, eh? Take off, you hoser. This makes me wonder if there's anything more I could do to this. I almost thought about doing red and like where the cuticles are, right in through here. I don't know. It painted up quick enough. I mean, to be honest, like, 1 hour and 45 minutes. Pretty good. Definitely think I would do it a little bit different the next time. Maybe try to keep it a little bit more Caucasian flesh tone, or maybe like a warm flesh tone, so it looks like there's a hand coming out of the wall at you. It might be kind of fun. But yeah, it's supposed to be mounted on the wall like that, pretty sure. Yeah, because the thing narrows here, so you put it in here and it slides up, so. There you go, there's the hand. Ooh, spooky. I'll get some photos of it and get it over to my friend that printed it. This thing, I'm gonna get away from that. I'm just gonna use this. There we go. It's time to figure out how I want to paint this guy. Well, we can at least start with the teeth. I've got the bones out, so I can at least get the teeth painted. We'll do that. We'll start with that, and we'll go from there. This thing's huge. What am I doing? Good grief. let that dry. So I've got some dark blue green here that I think I'm going to do a skin with. Got a big brush out here. Okay, looks pretty good. Alright, I like that dark blue green for his skin. That looks pretty darn good. And Raph is a little bit darker of skin. I can always darken it more too. I can run a black wash, black or brown wash over the top of it, which I'll probably end up doing because this thing's going to take me a while. Blind Jedi, good evening. Hello, how are you? Everybody's coming on. Want to go. Yay, turtles. Yep, so working on the Teenage Ninja Turtle bust. I finished up the 3D printed hand as well. Can't see it in that light because it's all washed out, but it is done. not my best work, but yeah, it'll work for now. Like I said, I might have my friend Chris print me out another one and I can redo it. So we're going to take a little bit of this Battle Mud wash. And we're going to go over the teeth. Because I want to give them some definition. And some depth. Hope all is well with you there, Blind Jedi. I was just telling Lead Logic that I busted butt and got all my winterizing stuff done today. So lawns are mowed, leaves are mulched. Snowblower has been brought out and started to make sure that that starts. So, it is, my birthday was on Thursday, and I got very spoiled. Hey, happy birthday, congratulations, man, you made it another year. That's awesome. Roll to see if wisdom plus one happened? Question mark, maybe? You know, I hit dex minus one, that's for sure. Yeah. Yeah, we're going to grab a little bit of pink. Because I want to do the gums. Yeah, dope. Don't worry, they're not going to stay this pink for long. Just want to get some color on here. It's not really showing on the bottom teeth. Alright, cool. Just on the top. Boy, did that dark, what's it called? Deep green blue, dark blue green. That really, yeah, that's where I wanted that. Looks good. Get some warm brown here. Gotta use my big brush for this. So I gotta do this bottom shell here. It smells good. So, Blind Jedi, what did you do to earn the minus one dex, like, besides getting another year older? Like, hopefully you didn't hurt yourself. I don't want anybody hurting themselves. Pretty much being older, yeah, okay. Alright. That's warranted. Okay, definitely like that warm brown for his inner, for his belly shell. Lead Logic says, I knocked over my stand with each pencil, pen, and paintbrush organized. Now it's time to reorganize. Yep, that sounds about right. I definitely think that we're going to do the back shell in this brown black. All right. This is cumbersome. Yeah, we get our big paintbrush. So the thing with this guy is I have to get him done in 10 hours. So I can't dink around too much. Well, once again, Blind Jedi, happy birthday. I hope this next year treats you very well. Should be enough. And I'm going to grab this brush. First base coats are on. Woo-hoo. That wash is done, so we can go in and redo the teeth. Quantum Reveries is raiding with a party of 16. Hey, Quantum Reveries, what's going on? Holy cow. What's happening, everybody? Welcome in, Raiders. Quantum Reveries, I hope you had a wonderful stream. What were you streaming? What were you doing? Having a great day painting pumpkin horrors. Awesome. I was working on a desiccated or dismembered arm and hand there for a while. Pretty much finished that up. It was a 3D print. This is also a 3D print. Now we're working on Raphael from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Just getting some base coats started on him and then working on the teeth here. So yeah, if you haven't been here before, my name is Tom. I am the Midwest Miniature Guy. I paint minis for gamers and collectors. You painted Reaper Minis Fritz Pumpkin Horror. Cool. Pretty sure I've seen that one. I should pick up some Halloween minis for next year. I've got a few creepy ones, but not really Halloween themed per se. Tomorrow night I'm going to be working on the Banshee from the Old Bones vampire level from their first Kickstarter. Grab her here in just a second. Where is she here? There she is. Is that little... that one there? We're gonna try and do her a more ethereal green color, though. Yeah, if you want to post that link to your Instagram, you certainly may. that's kind of what we got going there. So work on his teeth more. Alright, we'll take a look at that link here in just a second. Go ahead and click on over to Quantum Reverie's Instagram page there for a pic of what he was painting. Or they were painting, sorry, I guess I don't know if you're... Go take a look here. Oh, nice. Yeah, I bet you did have a lot of fun painting him. That's very cool. I dig that a lot. Nice job on him. Done. Gotta add more bass and get a nice glamour shot, yeah. I always try to do that too. Linus, yeah, that'll be nice to add. It'll be a nice addition to my game, Agnostic Pumpkin War Band, which a viewer named the Murder Gourds. There you go. Linus should not have summoned the Great Pumpkin. Run for your lives, indeed. Gonna use some of this polished bone as the eyes here. There, now it's looking better. Excuse me. Alright, we're gonna add a little Volupus pink to his gums. It's kind of a nice pink contrast paint here over the breast cancer awareness pink that we used. Here's a funny thing, I have a lot of Christmas themed menus too. I should paint them up and run some tabletop games in a Studio 54 Christmas field. There you go. That sounds like a lot of fun. So I think the skin is going to take me the longest. The mask will go fairly quick. That's still drying. best part about adventures, rescuing Santa Claus, he has the best presents. True. Alright, so I'm going to mix a little bit of this warm flesh into our, what's it called, warm brown? Yep, warm brown. And this is what's going to be for the front shell area. I kind of want to get it up to a gold kind of a color. But I think this will work for now. I do not yet. This one is actually a commission piece that I'm working on for one of my wife's high school friends who has been finally diving into their inner nerd. And so I get to paint up some of the stuff that he's been 3D printing. If I ever do get any more, though, that'd be super cool. So my favorite Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle was Leonardo, because he had the katanas on his back. So that'd be really cool if he had the katanas here. But much of this left. Donatello, yeah. Donatello was great. Alright, so this is raw sienna. This is what I'm going to use for my kind of gold brown color here. Quantum, have a great rest of your night. Get some rest. Streaming for 7 hours today? Holy cow. I'm up to almost 3 and I'm tired already. Goes by in a blink too. Yeah, I think the longest I ever did was 5. I don't know how those folks do it that do like the 24-hour streams. Like, I gotta sleep. I got a day job, man. Longest was over 7.5 hours. Your voice gave out, so you had to quit. Yeah, jeez Louise. Now, my day job is talking on the phone for 8 hours, so I couldn't stream for that for too long. I stream Sunday, Mondays, and Wednesdays, and Mondays and Wednesdays, and after like the 3rd hour, my voice is shot. Start sound like Barry White. You only stream Sundays 1 to 3 PST currently. Someday I'll do other regular days. There you go. Yeah, Sunday, Monday, and Wednesdays are the only days that I stream because I have other stuff going on those other days. Yep, good night, man. Be safe out there. Barry White coming at you. That's right. Can't get enough of your love, baby. trying to hold this thing. This thing's freaking heavy. It's not like a metal mini, but geez, the weighs. What do you think? Yay? Nay? I kind of like it. Once we get into the highlights, then it'll start looking better, because it'll start looking more like pale gold. I need a bigger brush for that area there, and for this area over here. Just do some quick overbrush. Texture. Give me 1 second here. So this is golden brown that we're putting over the top of that. Up a little bit. Now we're going to rub some Empire Gold. I'm just going to do a little stippling here where I create some texture. Like that. So I've taken this old beat up makeup brush and I've just grabbed a bunch of that paint, wiped some off, and I'm going around stippling in this color, this golden brown. Not golden brown, Empire Gold. Duh. Grab a little bit more of that, along with some ivory white. You're just going to mix that together. There, now it's got some texture to that shell. This paper towel is done. It's soaked. Time for a new one. Excuse me. Well, folks, it's 11 o'clock and I got an early morning, so I think I'm going to call it for the evening. Hope you all have a wonderful rest of your night. We're going to find someone to raid. We're going to raid Wapelius. He is painting. So y'all have a wonderful, wonderful rest of your evening. Give James Wapple some love. Today would have been his wife's birthday, and we lost her a couple of months ago to cancer. So give James some love, and we will see you all very soon.